Optical instruments are devices which are used to observe or magnify images of an object. There are two types of objects. Some objects are very tiny and which we have to see magnified image of tiny objects. Such an optical instrument is termed as microscopes. And when we see magnified image of far off or distant object, this is done by telescopes. So we will talk about microscopes and telescopes one by one. Starting with microscope. Microscope is a device which is used to observe a magnified image of tiny object. And first is simple microscope. So in microscopes, let's start with simple microscope. Simple microscope is just a convex lens. When convex lens is being used, in a particular case, it starts behaving as simple microscope. We commercially also call it as hand lens. What is that specific condition? When object is kept in between optical center and focus of a lens, you obtain a magnified, virtual and erect image of an object. Just have a look. I kept object here, AB. Same distance you can mark focus this side. Ray of light coming parallel passes through the focus. The ray of light passing through optical center moves straight. These two rays can never meet ahead because these are diverging in nature. So extend at back. Extend this ray also at back. And you will see it finally drop perpendicular on principal axis. So you have obtained a magnified image of an object AB. I am rubbing this so you can check and see the diagram clearly. Is that clear? And this image is obtained at least distance of distinct vision. Least distance of distinct vision is a distance at which a normal human eye can see without any stress, and its value is 25 centimeter. It is a fixed value. Now we will calculate magnifying power. Magnifying power of simple microscope. As per the definition, it is defined as the ratio of angle subtended by an image to the angle subtended by an object at the eye when both are at least distance of distinct vision. Now, eye is normally kept at the optical center, we assume. First condition, very important condition, is that both should be at least distance of distinct vision. As we know, image is formed at least distance of distinct vision, but object is not. So we geometrically marked out equivalent portion here at this position PV dash, and check this angle is alpha and this angle is beta. So M is equal to beta over alpha. For a small angle, you can write m is equal to tan theta over tan alpha. Now from right angle triangle A dash B dash O, you can get tan beta is equal to A dash B dash over B dash O. And from right angle triangle P B dash O, you can get tan alpha, that is A P B dash over B dash O. Substituting in equation 2, when you substitute these two equations in equation number 2, then M is equal to A dash B dash over AB. That's a normal formula which you have obtained in case of a convex lens earlier, as I told you. And if you remember, this formula finally in terms of distance of object and distance of image is V over U. That we have modified and given another formula V 1 minus V over F. Now here in this case V is equal to minus D. So you can say M is equal to 1 plus D over F. This is magnifying power of simple microscope. Is that clear? Second article we are going to do type of microscope, that is compound microscope. A compound microscope consists of two lenses. A lens which is kept very close to an object is termed as objective lens, while another lens which is through which image is being seen is termed as eyepiece lens. Objective lens is of a small focal length and a small aperture, while eyepiece lens is of large focal length, is of large aperture, and focal length is moderate, and moderate focal length. Moderate focal length means neither too large nor too small. This is what we use. Both the lenses are mounted at the ends of a tube coaxially. I mean to say optical center of both the lenses are lying in the same line. Let's see how to draw diagram for it. First you draw a small lens or objective lens. Draw a long principal axis. Mark a small focal length and same this side. Place an object AB here, tiny object. Draw a parallel line, ray, and pass it through focus. Draw another ray, pass it through optical center. Wherever it intersect, draw perpendicular. A dash B dash is image. Near this image, you can keep or make large lens. This will be your eyepiece lens. OE. Focus, and this image must lie in between focus and optical center of eyepiece lens. Rest you just follow the rules of obtaining image, you will get the image automatically. Ray passing through the focus, ray passing through optical center, extend at the back, draw perpendicular, A double dash, B double dash is final image. That's how an image is magnified in compound microscope. Is that correct? I repeated it. Tiny object kept in front of the small focal length and a small aperture objective lens. It forms an image at A dash B dash. A dash B dash serves as an object for eyepiece lens. Again, follow the rules of formation of image. One ray passes through the focus, another passes through the optical center. It won't meet ahead, so to extend it back, you will obtain final image A dash B dash. Magnification of compound microscope now. As far as definition is concerned, it is same. That is a ratio of an angle made or subtended by the final image to the angle subtended by an object when both are lying at least distance of distinct vision. And as we know, final image is formed at least distance of distinct vision D. So I put this object, equivalent object PV here, PV double dash. This is an angle alpha, and this is an angle beta. This is distance of an object. This is the distance of an image formed by objective lens. So by definition, M is equal to beta over alpha. That we can put it as tan beta over tan alpha again. Equation number one. From right angle triangle A double dash B double dash OE, you can get tan beta is equal to A double dash B double dash over B double dash OE. And from right angle triangle P B double dash OE, we can put tan alpha is equal to A double dash B double dash, sorry, P B double dash, this is P B double dash over B double dash OE. Substitute in equation number 1, M is equal to, you will get A double dash B double dash over P B double dash. This you can write it as A double dash B double dash AB. Geometrically, PBB double dash we have drawn equal to AB. And this you can put it as A double dash B double dash over A dash B dash into A dash B dash over AB. What I have done here? Simply multiply it with A dash B dash and divide by A dash B dash, which is very much mathematically acceptable. Now you see, AB is the height of an object, A dash B dash is height of an image formed by objective lens. If I talk individually, then this becomes a magnifying power of objective lens. A dash B dash serves as an object for eyepiece lens, and final image is formed A double dash B double dash. So this serves as magnifying power of eyepiece lens. So net magnifying power of telescope, or sorry, compound microscope is product of magnifying power of objective lens and eyepiece lens. That's why practically when you see microscopes in bio lab or physics lab, on eyepiece lens it is always marked as 5x, 10x. It means the image of a tiny object is magnified these many times to the actual size. Now, M naught is a working as a simple lens, so you can put it as V naught over U naught is minus, so you can put mod, and ME, that is magnifying power of this, it is serving as simple microscope, so you can keep it like this. So this is a magnifying power of compound microscope. There are two more special cases. Number one, when since focal length is very small, in this case number one, I can say since focal length is small, so case one, if U naught is equal to F naught and V naught is equal to L, where L is the length of the tube. Length of tube. Tube means distance between objective and eyepiece lens. Right? So this formula will turn into M is equal to minus, you can write it as minus L over F naught 1 plus D over FE. Case 2, when final image is formed at infinity, then you can ignore this one factor from here and you can write M is equal to minus L over F naught into D over FE. This formula is very important because most of the questions and examinations are based on it.